Hi folks, another sea picture, another made up one based on memory, mainly memory of having done lots of them. Just put my script brushes in their respective little holders. Okay. Right, okay, I'm going to do a bit of brush. I had quite a bit of night, so I will draw a horizon. Something like that. I'm looking at Watergate Bay. And then we'll have a few rocks. Let's see, coming in there, so, something like that. I'll try and paint around that. You guys use a knife for all this, but I want to get a, oh, I haven't got the colours in. Just done a watercolour for YouTube. Upload, not a great one. Bit disappointing really. But my heart's in oil painting for the foreseeable future anyway. I just love it. Just love doing it. It's a lot of fun. I love the modelling that you can do and the changing, the blending. That's not to say I'm going to ignore watercolours, I'll still do watercolours. I've got lots on Etsy. Not Etsy, on Patreon. And I shall need to buy some paints pretty soon. So folks, Patreon, a good way to go. Right, I'm going to use my lovely brush for this. So I will get some nice lovely blue. Some red in there. Okay, now we'll use some oil. I've mixed the oil, the linseed oil. Well, I haven't mixed it, I've just dropped a few drops of fast drying oil into it. So we'll get a rough brush. A bit of oil. That's the only problem, you do your drawing and then you cover it up. Now what happened is the paint will, or the oil in the paint will soak into the paper and it'll start to dry and go a bit tacky, which is lovely. Now that's quite a busy sky, isn't it, mate? Right, I'll leave that. You better go into the. Well, you can use knives. You can just sort of put some on. Good stormy sky, look at that. Gotta put some Payne's grey on. Okay, quite like that. Thanks, Ray. So we've got knife work in the sky, and knife work is going into the horizon now. That's a nice, sort of bluey ochre-y. See what happens here. I like that sky. Right, I'm going to put in my bit of distance lead now. Okay, right. We've got a bit of light colour in there. Now, I'm going to put in some white, I'm not sure whether it's right. That. Not sure about that, let's come over it. Right, this is my smaller knife. Right, I'll get this other clip in. Ah, of course I'm having none. Right, okay, now let's get some nice colour in. A nice dark rich green on it. Right, some white. My wife pinched a bit of white oil paint to paint a windowsill inside. We've just had our kitchen just double glazed. When we moved into this house, it wasn't sort of quite as popular to have double glazing, but the replacement really. It wasn't particularly burglar proof, but nothing's burglar proof to a determined thief, is it? Oh, let's have a little bit of a. Okay, so light against dark, it's sort of second nature eventually that it's obvious really that if you want something to look dark, put it next to something light and so on. Okay, that's coming on. Not quite good enough there. Bit of off-white there. Just get that counter change. Okay, that's all right. Put some dark in there, and we can justify that later with a bit of a. Let's just get in some. I've just gone over where I was going to put that to. I forget what I was going to say now. I'm trying to get that lovely colour there in the sea and ripples. Right, let's get some yellow ochre. Do you know, I'm quite excited by my brush and knife sky. So let's get some nice lighter ochre colour with lots of white. I've got to add a few rocks into this. Just a bit of red ochre. I Add a bit of red with that ochre. Right. It takes a while just to cover all this. I'll fathom out the ripples in a moment, all the waves. Let's just get all this on. Get some yellow. bit bitty. Shadow in it. Okay, but I don't think I can do much more to that. Right, okay, I quite like that. Take this off, this dismantle the board. Put it about. Oh god, that hurts my... It's really tough, those things. Your fingers, put on the double mount. Okay, well, that's a bit different, isn't it? Hope you like it, folks.